health departments are responsible for the overall public health, safety, and well-being of the communities they serve. One critical role that health departments play is to ensure that people are safe when eating or buying food outside their homes by conducting food service health inspections. In the previous videos in this four-part series, we provided an overview of what health inspections are, how they work, and how they are scored. One underlying theme that we've tried to highlight is that there are many nuances and differences between health departments. In this video, we shed some light on why that is. In the US, many people are familiar with the Food and Drug Administration, FDA, the US federal regulatory body that is responsible for setting national food safety standards. However, the FDA typically does not have the authority to enforce regulations against these standards. That responsibility lies with local health departments, of which there are over 2,500 distinct ones in the US alone. Why so many? Well, depending on the state you're in, your local health department, responsible for food safety, may be at the state, county, district, or even city level. For example, the state of Kansas has one central state-level health department that serves its entire population. While in the state of Massachusetts, food safety inspections are carried out by 350 different city-level health departments. Nearly all states use some version of the FDA food code to inform their food safety standards, but typically allowed their constituent local health departments to tweak the food code for their local populations. In short, inspection enforcement behavior, codes, scores, and other factors are largely non-standardized across the country. Here's a non-exhaustive breakdown, along with some examples of how health departments can differ. Accessibility of inspection results. In some jurisdictions, you can easily view inspection results online at your local health department's website, whereas in other places, you have to contact the health department and make a request to access records. Inspection criteria. The types of violations an inspector checks for during a visit, as well as which violations are considered critical or not, can vary dramatically. This is something we explored in part 2. Publication of inspection scores. Some agencies publish inspection scores to make it easier for consumers to understand the food safety performance of establishments, whereas others don't. This is something we explored in part 3. Enforcement leniency. Agencies can also vary significantly on how many violations they tend to cite on average per inspection. For example, inspectors in Florida cite on average 5 or more violations per inspection, while the average in Delaware is less than 1. Inspection frequency. How frequently establishments get inspected also varies. For example, on average, restaurants in Idaho are subject to routine inspections once every year, while restaurants in Arizona are inspected more than twice as often. These are just some examples of how complex the health inspection enforcement and information landscape is in the US, and we observe similar issues in many other countries globally as well. No wonder then that consumers, food service operators, and industry providers alike are often left confused and unsure of how to make sense of health inspection data. At Hazel Analytics, we seek to change this and move the needle on food safety and public health through our data-driven technologies that better inform, connect, and enable action amongst the various stakeholders in the food service and retail industries. If you're interested in learning more about how we build and leverage artificial intelligence and machine learning technologies, check out the video below. And for more insights and news on food safety and regulatory compliance, subscribe to our channel below, or visit us at hazelanalytics.com.